How's everybody doing tonight? There are a lot more people here than that. How are we doing tonight? Everybody good? All right, that's what I like to hear. Welcome to the University of Utah Jazz Ensemble and Jazz Repertory Ensemble Concert. We have a very special guest tonight by the name of Wycliffe Gordon. Please give him a round of applause. Now, I believe that most of you are here for me specifically, not for Wycliffe, but if you came to see Wycliffe, he will perform, I promise you that, okay? At this time, we're gonna start off tonight's concert with the Jazz Repertory Ensemble, conducted by one of our TA students, Mr. Evan Taylor. Please give him a round of applause.
Thank you. How's everyone doing tonight? So the first tune we're going to play for you is a composition by Thelonious Monk. He was a very playful musician, and the name of it is Epistrophe. And what an epistrophe is it's a repetition of phrases. So you're going to hear a lot of repetition of the same melody. This melody came to me just one morning. I woke up and I was like dancing in my kitchen. So I don't know, the arrangement came out of nowhere. It was like one of those things that just kind of came together. So here it is, Epistrophe. Thank you. Thank you again. That was Epistrophe by Thelonious Monk. This next composition we're going to do is Duke Ellington composition, and our saxophone player Cameron Gallagher is going to say a few words about it.
All right, so as you guys know, the incredible Wycliffe Gordon is here. And before I introduce this piece, I just want to say a quick little anecdote. I think it relates perfectly to the piece we're about to play. So the students here are incredibly privileged and just amazed that we're grateful that Mr. Gordon could be here and share his knowledge with us. It's been incredible. He's been here teaching us, you know, the past 2 days. Just we've been picking his brain, and we want to thank Mr. Chris Johnson for making that happen, and just Chris in general. He's amazing. But what I want to share with you, it was very significant, and I never really thought about this, and it was last night. Mr. Gordon, he brought up in his master class, he said, he shared a story about Louis Armstrong, and he said, Louis always, he said, he played for someone he loved. I never thought about that before, and it really struck a chord with me, and I think this next piece, I think it's safe to say we're all going to play for someone we love, and I know I definitely am. Hope you enjoy. This next piece is Duke Ellington's In a Sentimental Mood.
Thank you.
Again, you heard from Cameron Gallagher on the saxophone. Peyton Wong on the trombone. Sungmi Kim on the piano. Connor Anderson on the guitar. Without further ado, we're going to move on to our next song, and before we do that, we're gonna invite a very, very special guest to the stage. We're very excited to have him here. It's been an incredible experience just the last 2 days, just having him around. The energy that he's brought into this campus and the energy that he's brought to the students is out of this world. I mean, I've never seen anybody turn an entire building into just like a magical place, like with his presence. So, without further ado, Mr. Wycliffe Gordon.
Right now, we're going to do an original composition entitled "What You're Dealing With," and it's a tune that kind of asks the question, but it's also the answer. Sometimes you want to hear jazz, sometimes you want to hear classical, gospel, maybe rap, hip hop, but every now and then we're in different spaces where we want to deal with this or that, and it's always cool. So without further ado, this is "What You're Dealing With."
Thank you.
How you guys doing so far? Yeah? How about another round of applause for the Jazz Repertory Ensemble under the direction of Evan Sullivan? And please give it up once more for our special guest, Mr. Wycliffe Gordon. It is very packed tonight. This is very beautiful. If you have room and you see room, if you can squeeze in, we can be a big family. We can make room for some of our guests that are standing here. That would be nice. If you can't, that's okay too. At this time, we're going to have the Jazz Ensemble take the stage and get set up and tune. And we're going to keep going through our program. So we'll be back with you in one moment. Please give it up for the University of Utah Jazz Ensemble. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Please give it up for Mr. Tony Ellison at the piano. We also heard from Zane Peterson on the alto sax. And Mr. Gus Bogdano on the trumpets. At this time, we're going to feature our trombone section with a wonderful arrangement by our guest artist, Mr. Wycliffe Gordon. And we're also going to welcome to the stage this time our guest artist, Mr. Wycliffe Gordon.
Thank you.
Mr. Wycliffe, Gordon. At this time, we'd like to call to the stage our vocalist, Miss Anais Samuels.
One, two. We're gonna do one of those good old good ones, as Louis Armstrong used to say, in the style of Louis and Ella. And yes, go ahead, don't do that. This one is entitled "Our Love Is Here to Stay."
It's up. Are we working? Just 1 second for technical difficulties.
How's everyone doing this evening? Cool, because we're playing music, and I'm going to say this. Normally, I'd say it later in the show. If you're not having a good time, it's probably your fault. We're playing music. We make music for a living, and it's a pleasure for us to share the joy and love that we have for music with you. So thank you for joining us on this night. There are many other things you could have been doing, but I'm happy that you decided to come here to be with us.
Check.
We good? I hope I remember my part.
That we know may just be a sick face. Every time I wake up. do pretty well till after sundown. Supper time, I'm feeling safe, but it really gets bad round midnight. Memories always start round midnight, midnight.
Give it up one more time for Miss Anais Samuels. And how about a warm round of applause for Mr. Eric Newman. And I also want to recognize on that last song we had Mr. Elliot Stanton on the trumpet. We're going to welcome Mr. Gordon back to the stage, and at this time we're going to do a medley of Gershwin songs that I originally arranged for the Count Basie Orchestra. This was part of a dedication to Basie, Ella, and Pops. This is a medley featuring all Gershwin songs. Hope you enjoy.
Happy love, happy time. I feel so
British Museum had lost its charm.
You wear your pajamas.
did do do that. Oh yeah.
Once again, Ms. Annie Samuels. We also heard from Evan Taylor on the trumpet. And come on, Utah, give a big welcome to Mr. Wycliffe, Gordon. All right, before we do this next number, it's story time. You guys okay with that?
Yeah.
All right. You don't sound like you're okay with it. You okay with it?
Yeah.
So I want to tell you a little bit. How many of you remembers this? But I want to tell you about the first time I met Wycliffe Gordon. So this was the summer before my senior year of college. And my father, who's here, everybody say hi to Kurt Johnson real quick. So the summer before my senior year of high school, my brother was doing an internship in New York City. And my dad and I drove him out to drop him off for the summer. And my dad knew I was into jazz, and he said, hey, look through the Village Voice and pick out any concert that you want to see. Just let me know what you want to see, and let's go hear some music. And, you know, I only knew a couple names in music. I knew, like, Wynton Marsalis, Roy Hargrove, Miles Davis, who I couldn't go see for obvious reasons. And I saw the name Roy Hargrove, and I saw he was doing a tribute to Louis Armstrong at the Knitting Factory. So I said, okay, Dad, let's go to the Knitting Factory. Roy Hargrove's playing, that's going to be great. So we go down there, it's this amazing show, and there's this fantastic vocalist slash trombone player just annihilating the stage, this man over here. I mean, it was just out of sight, unreal. As much as I was there to see Roy Hargrove, that stopped very quickly, and I was 100% there to see Mr. Gordon. After the concert, my dad trying to, you know, pump me up. I used to be shy, if you can believe that. I'm serious, I was like, right, Dad?
Yes.
Yeah, very much. So, I'm just terribly, terribly shy. My dad said, listen, Roy Hargrove is walking up the dressing room right now. When are you ever going to have another opportunity to say hi to Roy Hargrove and introduce yourselves? I said, okay, all right, I can do this. I walk up, I'm like, Mr. Hargrove, it's so nice to meet you. I'm a trumpet player. And he walked right past me. Nothing to do with me. He was busy. You know, he's in between sets. I understand now, as a professional musician, you don't always have time, but he really didn't have time. He wasn't interested. So I ran back to my dad with my tail between my legs and said, okay, I'll never do that again. That was terrifying and upsetting and very disturbing. But then afterwards, we walk out of the Knitting Factory. We're still on such a high from seeing this concert. It was really incredible. And we walk outside, and we see Mr. Gordon over there catching a cab. So my dad gives me the exact same speech verbatim. Hey, you know, hey, look, when are you ever going to have an opportunity? You might never see this man again for your entire life, which is really funny right now. Just want to say. He's like, man, you got to go up and introduce yourself. And of course, I'm even more traumatized. But I say, okay, I'm going to do it. So I walk over. He's literally about to walk into a cab. I'm like, Mr. Gordon, it's the worst timing on my part. But he was so gracious. He said, hey, man, it's so nice to meet you. Oh, you're from Detroit? Oh, that's great. Wonderful. I love Detroit. Marcus Belgrave. So listen, man, I'm on my way to the Village Vanguard to play a set with Eric Reed. But I want to talk to you. Here's my card. And he handed me a card with his phone number and his email address and said, call me tomorrow so we can talk because we don't have time to talk to you right now. I'm thinking, like, how did I go from being ignored to this man handing me his personal phone number? And so I was like, all right, he can't possibly mean he got off in the cab. And the next day, my dad's like, you're calling him. You got to call him. Come on, man. And my brother's egging me on, like, you got to call him. So anyway, I go ahead and give him a call. My handshake, Mr. Gordon, I met you at the concert. Oh, yeah, Detroit. Yeah, it's great. Great to hear from you, man. He said, listen, I'm playing tonight with a really good group. This guy named Eric Reed. I didn't know Eric Reed was. I was a little slow. This great artist named Eric Reed, he's at the Village Vanguard. You guys should come out tonight. So I went, myself, my dad, my brother, and we went out to the Village Vanguard, and we were sitting even closer than Tyler and Isabel are to me right now. I mean, Wycliffe Slide was almost hitting me in the face as he was playing. We were in the front row. And if you've ever been to the Village Vanguard, I mean, it's about the size of my office. It's really, really tiny. And it was just this beautiful concert. I mean, just really quick to give you the lineup. It was Mr. Gordon on trombone, Eric Reed on piano, Herlin Riley was playing drums, we had Marcus Printup on trumpet, we had Wes Anderson on alto sax,
I believe we have Walter Blanding on tenor sax. I can't remember who was playing bass that night.
Probably Ben Wolf,
right. So it was a couple of okay musicians on stage. And it's just this beautiful concert. And then not too long after that, I stayed in touch with Mr. Gordon. I'd send him an email. And I'm just this punk high school kid. He hadn't even heard play yet. And he would reply to my emails and answer my questions. And he came and he did a clinic with the Detroit Symphony Orchestra Youth Jazz Ensemble. It's called the Civic Jazz Orchestra. And he did a clinic, and he said, hey, well, I just started teaching. This is my first year at Michigan State University. When it came time to go to college, we had something called on-site admissions. So I went up to my counselor and said, well, what colleges do you want to apply to? There's a representative here from a couple of schools. I said, Michigan State University. I sat down, I filled out my application, and I got in right there on the spot. And then everybody's like, well, what other schools are you applying to? I'm like, I got into Michigan State, and Wycliffe Gordon is there. I'm not going anywhere else. Are you kidding me? There's no way. So freshman year, I know it's a long story, but get over it. All right. So freshman year, I get on campus, and I start meeting a couple people, and somebody says, hey, there's a jam session going on. And I'm a freshman, like, okay, cool. We didn't have the issue we had here. We could get in anywhere. I've been going to jazz clubs since I was 14. I'm sorry. I apologize. And so we go to the first jam session. It's at this bar. And then I'm not expecting the Wycliffe Gordon to just show up at this student-run jam session. He was in town. The semester was starting, and there was music being played. And so he was there. And he played with us all night. Afterwards, he gave me a ride home. I was like, hey, man, how are you getting acclimated to the campus? You doing all right? I'm like, you're famous. You know, and I had to listen to his CDs. Anyway, long story short, eventually he did leave Michigan State, and I continued on and got my degrees there. But then some years later, a good friend of mine was working as a copyist for Mr. Gordon, and I was the person she always called whenever she ran into a problem. She'd say, hey, Chris, I'm working on the chart for Wycliffe. How do I do X, Y, Z in Finale to clean up the charts? And I would tell her. So when she got busy, she made the mistake of saying, hey, well, for this one job, you should use Chris. And he gave me a call. Hey, Chris, good to hear from you. And then I've been his copyist for the last 8 years. I'm sorry, Lynn. And he's become a great friend. He's an amazing mentor, one of the most humble and dedicated and amazing educators, musicians, singer, vocalist, trumpet player. I said singer and vocalist, trombonist, clarinet, 23 instruments, anything. One of my favorite human beings on earth. Please welcome one more time to sing his rendition of Dream a Little Dream, Mr. Wycliffe.
Wow, what a story. Yeah, this is actually Fletcher Henderson's arrangement, but it was so hip. Sometimes you just want to do exactly what they did, and this is, again, Louie and Ella, and it's one of my favorites, so without further ado, dream a little dream of me. Both stars, but I linger on dear.
this honor.
Let's hear it again for the songbird. When you're traveling, you don't get a chance to check the emails all the time, and I didn't check it. I noticed it. So the students here are so nice and thoughtful. And she sent me an email, just said, I look forward to working with you. And since I've been here, the time has been really quick, but it's been wonderful. How about it again for the musicians of this group? I'm fine. I'm really touched by Chris's story, and I'm not going to tell one, but I do want to say that one of the greatest compliments that we can be paid as professional musicians of the sea, we're all students of the music, so we will always be that. But at one time, for just maybe a year or so, former student, to see him doing so well, that's just it's great. It's wonderful. I love what he's doing here at the university, what he's done in terms of playing with the Count Basie Band, and thank God he's my copyist, because I can depend on him, I can count on him. I call him, I say, hey, I need this big band score or these orchestra parts, and you know, if you can get it to me by Friday at 5 o'clock, and never, every time, without fail, it'll make me 4:53. Bing! It pops up on my computer, and I mean, you know, he'll stay up through the minute, and that's something that you can really appreciate, you know, and be proud of, that you see that when folks go out and they take seriously what they do, and they put their love into their craft, and that's what these students are doing, and this is what we do when we travel. So this next tune we're going to play is an original composition, and it's entitled We're Still Here, and it was done for the soundtrack to a silent movie of Boston shows. The second one I got a chance to compose for, and of course, I don't have any of the CDs here, but we just ordered some more that didn't do you any good tonight, and even if I had CDs, I'd probably tell you that if you want to get something reminiscent of the night, to pick up a CD, we're not playing any songs from those CDs, but we're playing a lot of the same notes. So, anyway, but we're going to play this for you, and it's kind of a testament to my experience as a musician, growing up in, being born in Waynesboro, Georgia, growing up in Augusta. It kind of tells a little bit of my story. There's a work song. We grew up in the country. And, you know, there's remnants of, you know, gospel. Anyway, call and response, the things that you would hear, the elements and all of music. And anyway, without further ado, we're going to play for you. We're Still Here, and He's All Right. Thank you all for coming out tonight. How about for the band? Our saxophone section. Our trombone section. Our trumpet section. Last but not least, our rhythm section. I said I'm gonna talk my talk, and I'm gonna walk my walk. I'm gonna sing my song, and I'm gonna sing it all day long. I'm gonna clap my hands.
Bye.
Chris Chenay. Ha ha ha!
Philip.
Give it up for Chris Wilson on the baritone sax. Cameron Gallagher on tenor sax. Marine Stouts working on occasion. Yeah, Andrew Carlson on alto sax. Zane Peterson on the alto sax. Mr. Eric Newman on tenor. In the rhythm section, Mr. Tony Ellison on piano. Nick the Man Coulter on guitar. Alicia Ripley on the double bass. Matt, not to be confused with Chris Wilson on the drums. In the trombone section, give it up for Peyton Wong on bass trombone. Emily Wales on the trombone. We have Miss Chloe Ponto on the trombone. Vivian Baldwin. In the trumpet section, Gus Bogdano on the trumpet. You heard from all night, Mr. Evan Taylor on the trumpet. Mr. Elliot Spencer. I'm sorry, Elliot Staden on the trumpet. I'm sorry. Spencer Shaw on the trumpet. How about a round of applause for our vocalist, Ms. Anais Samuel? And a very, very, very special, special thank you. The great Mr. Wycliffe. Thank you so much.
How about it for Mr. Chris Johnson, who put the show together? Thank y'all for coming out. Good night.
Peace.